ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Cyclone Saturday Night. I am Remarkable Randall Reigns, and this is the Worldwide Wrestling Network. We want to thank everyone for stopping by and checking out the WWWN online here on YouTube. Thank you, everyone who has subbed and liked and been a part of our transition so far to YouTube, and thank you for this opportunity to bring virtual wrestling to you on demand every Monday, Tuesday, and Saturday. Ladies and gentlemen, we have an incredible lineup of matches for you here this evening, and we are starting it off with some low division action featuring Yvette DeSoto and Sugar Kane. Once again, a reminder, Sugar Kane is the number one contender for the Worldwide Wrestling Network Women's Championship held by Encantadora. Yvette DeSoto is a longtime rival of Encantadora throughout Mexico and South America. Is Sugar Kane looking to use Yvette DeSoto as some form of a potential warm-up? Let's take this to ringside and find out. And that is the music of Yvette DeSoto, who will be participating in the Mildred Burke Invitational, which kicks off with our first round matches next week on Tuesday night on Glow. Yvette, world famous as a luchadora throughout South America and Mexico. And that leaves the number one contender, Sugar Kane.
Oh, so good, baby, out of this world. Look so sweet, fell in love with your curves. Every time you speak, conversation like stir. S-U-G-A-R, you ain't her. Oh, honey, honey, put money on that bird. Let's keep it in the circle, do everything I deserve. Baby, want your sugar, I'm ready to get served.
Sugar. Oh, honey, honey.
Oh, sorry, I love this song.
You are my king, girl.
And Sugar Kane from Megalomaniac. Looking to face down Yvette DeSoto. And the referee rings the bell. And here we go. Forearm shot by Yvette. And multiple forearms. But in Sugar, able to come back, dropping Yvette with a suplex. Forearm shot, that was telegraphed, and Sugar got one of her own, and a big right hand by Yvette DeSoto. Irish whip sending Sugar into the ropes. Jump over, drop down, scientific as it can be, and look at that reversal into the snap there. Absolutely incredible athleticism on display in these first few moments. But DeSoto stomping on Sugar. Sugar taking down Yvette. And this would be a great warm-up match for Sugar Kane in facing Encantadora, and already trying to eliminate some of that lucha style, which is known for a little bit of devil may care, even though Yvette wrestles more of the technico style, more technical than the junior heavyweight style of Lucha Libre. But, oh, Sugar with that clothesline. God, and the taunt. And Sugar Kane now pulling Yvette in, stomping the arm. And now it is all Sugar Kane attacking the leg of Yvette. Working the arms again. Just completely breaking down Yvette sort of cover, and Yvette kicks out. Elbow shot sends Sugar Kane back, and Sugar just pushing back Yvette DeSoto, and look at that! Backslide driver straight onto the head. Double knee drop, flip into the moonsault with those knees. And now Kane looking to work the old school body scissors, squeezing the life out of Yvette DeSoto. And able to get all of that submission attempt, and it looks like she might be setting up. No, cut off. The sugar rush was cut off, and Yvette rolling to the outside following Sugar's clothesline. DeSoto trying to wake herself up, but catches one of Kane's fast right hands. Sugar rolling out to the outside, but second guessing it. Might be looking to take a count out victory here. That would be thinking like a number one contender. Why fight more than you have to? Save yourself for the big match with the women's champion. But at that, sky twisting arm drag by DeSoto. Attempting a Soleil kick there and a right hand. Oh, with a kip up. Hurricane Rock taking down Sugar. Sugar trapped by that alley-oop into the powerbomb, and now stomping the legs is Yvette DeSoto. And Yvette, with the suplex putting down Kane. And now Sugar is in trouble. Yvette knows multiple dangerous maneuvers from the corner. It looks like she is tying up Sugar in the tree of woe. And a backcracker! Backcracker from the elevated position. But wait, what a reversal. But wait a minute. Oh, drop kick by DeSoto, taking down Sugar. Yvette trying to get herself set up for some, and get her a springboard. And they don't call it high risk for no reason. But it might have been a pulley suckering in Kane for that arm drag. Forearm shot sends her back. And there we are, back to square one in the corner. Quick cover by Yvette, but Sugar able to get the right shoulder up. But here comes Yvette. Solid kick, and looks like she's going for that cutthroat backbreaker. That is, since her return, has been a signature maneuver, a trademark of sorts. Kick out by Kane. And now Yvette going up to the top rope gingerly. And look at this move! sugar after that backcracker came and pulled through, as DeSoto thinks that she is isolating a weakness in Sugar Cane. Sugar fighting back the elbow across the knee, Irish whip into the corner and able to nail that clothesline. Almost like a running ridge hand across the throat. Deep arm drag by Kane. Hammer, fireman's carry by Yvette. And these two are not slowing down. DeSoto attacking with forearms. And, oh! A released German suplex by Yvette. DeSoto is now pummeling Kane into the ring. And this is only going to get worse, it seems, folks. One more time, I think that Yvette is going to be looking for that back cracker, and it connects right at the base of the spine. DeSoto in complete control of Sugar, but Sugar able to get a reversal, handful of hair. Both of these women trying to do anything that they can to win. An event with a chop, multiple chops, just chopping down the Sugar. And DeSoto, unclear about what she might need to do next. Kane crawling, trying to get up, and oh, I don't know who got the worst of that. DeSoto again, this time from the opposite corner, gingerly climbing up her perch. And now waiting, oh, and Kane! Sugar Kane gets the knees up. Big right hand by Sugar, and then fighting back. DeSoto, and going for the release German one more time, but she is slowing down, getting very methodical in these attacks, going for the cover, full body press now, two, and Kane able to kick out. Sugar able to drop Yvette with the clothesline. What a recovery there. After getting out of that arm wrench, dropping her with a running clothesline, Yvette just a little quicker over the draw with that kick. And a drop kick right to the spine. DeSoto working over the back of Sugar Cane very clearly. And now, oh, tornado DDT. Almost shades of Chavo Guerrero Jr. with that tornado DDT. Looking to pick the leg, and Kane with the arm wrench and the elbow attack right to the arm has got DeSoto up. And wait a minute, DDT. And Sugar Cane has got to play some defense here. So leg kick by Yvette. Sugar bringing it back into the ring. But caught by that stun gun. DeSoto ripping Cane and just nailing her with that big right hand, and look at this! Arm rich Hurricane Rana placing Sugar Cane right into position. And again, for this, straight jacket backbreaker. DeSoto with the cover lateral press, deep leg hook. And the frustration on the veteran DeSoto's face is very apparent. Kane attempting to fight back, using the rope as a weapon. And wait a minute. Kane, the Sugar Rush connects. Cover right dead center. 1, 2, 3. And Sugar Cane
with the victory. Look so sweet, better love what you purge. Every time you see your conversation, I'm S-U-G-A-R, you ain't her. Oh, honey, put money on that bird. Let's keep it in the circle, do everything I deserve. They don't want you sugar, I'm ready to get served.
Sugar. Gentlemen, over the course of the last few weeks, we have had a standoff of sorts between Matt Spade and Jack Sanders. And Matt Spade has interjected himself into this real-life issue between Israel Hare and Jack Sanders. And personalities are boiling over due to these individuals' interactions in other promotions. And Matt Spade, the Ace of Spades, looking to prove that he can be a dominant force in the light heavyweight division, and putting a target on the back of Jack Sanders. But Jack Sanders, even though he is in contention for the Junior Heavyweight Championship, has a deep, abiding personal issue with Israel Hare stemming from his debut match at on Cyclone Saturday night 2 months ago. Israel Hare and Damian Knight beat Jack Sanders like a rented mule. And you've got to believe that Jack Sanders is going to be looking at this match tonight between Matt Spade and Israel Hare. And here comes Matt Spade,
making his way to the ring from El Paso,
really,
Texas, weighing in
has
at
made
220
himself as the Ace
pounds,
Spade.
Matt Ace.
He feels that he deserves to be top dog because of his training, refuses to use entrance music because he feels that he is. Doesn't deserve it. The fans' adulation should be enough. Crazy, and we just, this is energy that comes and goes with Israel Hare is frightening. You never know who you're going to get. Are you going to get Israel Hare, the straight up technician, or are you going to get the maniac wild man? And Hare and Spade square off next and referee calls for the bell, and Israel taking down Matt Spade, single leg takedown, attacking the knee. But Spade answering back the shoulder block. Spade giving this match after coming out and observing the match between Jack Sanders and Israel Hare 2 weeks ago. And Spade wants to see if he can also get a victory on Israel Hare like Jack Sanders, playing psychological games. And but Israel Hare is the wrong person to be playing mind games with, and so is Ripper Jack Sanders. In another time, in another place, at another opportunity, Israel Hare and Jack Sanders could probably be tag team partners. They'd probably be two of a kind. And look at this, is breaking down. Spade throwing hands with a brawler. And look at this, Spade looking to turn tail and run. And he's leaving. But no, Sanders, that's Jack Sanders. Jack Sanders from behind, sending Matt Spade back in, saying you're gonna finish this match. Big hip drop by Israel Hare. And wait a minute, whoa. Looked like he was going for a backbreaker, but Spade able to break out of it, pop over Israel, taking down the leg, breaking possible hyperextension could be there. Now, just going after every body part he can, and Hare kicks out. Spade attempting to make short work if he can, but he's already tried to take a shortcut and take the loss because he was afraid of what this maniac might do. And Hare going for the cover, kick out by Spade. And Spade with a deep arm drag, hip toss variation. And it looks like Spade going back to the leg, turning it into a figure four, inverted figure four. Just tying it up in a knot, but wait, just Hare just can be a wonderful technician, but also goes for those shortcuts. Now stomping Matt Spade and going for the cover. I'm surprised he's not reaching for the rope for more leverage. And, oh, right across the face of Spade. And Israel taking his time. And now paying back Spade, hyperextending the leg. Spade with that punch looked a little bit low to me. Whip by Israel, clothesline, sending Spade reeling. both of these men taking time to recover. Oh, and a cheap kick right to the chest. Jawbreaker creating a little bit of distance for Spade. Spade, Irish whip, sending Israel over the top rope. And, oh, what a snap, man. The velocity and the torque on that neck. Oh, but Hare able to dodge that attack and now laying in these clubbing blows. The double axe handle right to the back. Hare quickly going for the cover. Spade pushing to get up. Multiple covers in this match. Hip toss by Spade. And Matt just showing his utter frustration and disdain for Israel. Now going back to that technical stance, attacking the arms and legs. Go over to quick cover again. And every time Matt Spade attempts to go for the cover, you hear the chorus of boos. DDT! Snap DDT cover, two! And Spade, frustrated, wiping the sweat off his face, and bringing that figure four back, dropping the elbow across the head. And wait a minute, Matt Spade picking up, wonderful suplex. And looks like he's going for two of a kind. And an, oh, spine tingler. The grimace on the face of Israel Hare. Now he's following it up. Look at this variation of the Texas Cloverleaf. Snapping it in. Is Hare going to tap? And now going for the cover. One, two. Almost reminiscent as of Ripper, Jack Sanders putting Israel Hare to sleep. Almost like Spade was attempting to replicate that victory by going for a submission and being the cover. Armdrag taking down Matt Spade. Israel Hare might be back in control of this match. And he is sending Spade into the top turnbuckle 10 times. Absolutely disorienting. Big kick sending back Israel Hare. Hare answers with a knee right to the gut. And a low blow. And the referee calls for the bell. But this makes Matt Spade the victor after that low blow. An absolutely insane ending to a match. Israel Hare venting his frustration with the fact that he is being treated as a pawn by both Matt Spade and Jack Sanders, and exploding on Sanders, dropping him with the low blow. And Matt Spade with the disqualification victory. And up next is the rivalry that the locker room continuously talks about and the social media is yearning about. Scott Columbus Jr. and Britt Diamond, as well as the Law Dog, have been going back and forth on social media regarding the outcome of the Krampus Night match that saw Britt Diamond and Scott Columbus Jr. being the last two remaining individuals in that match. Scott Columbus Jr. won the number one contendership for Montezuma Cortez's junior heavyweight title. And Britt Diamond feels that he is the, well, true number one contender. And Britt Diamond has once again called out Scott Columbus Jr. on social media and SCJ and the booking committee, with the blessing of Gibson Ellis, has given Britt Diamond another chance to face Scott Columbus Jr. And let's take this right to ringside. And wait a minute, there is Prince Britt Diamond. And here comes SCJ. And SCJ laying in some big blows. A few weeks ago, we saw Britt Diamond attack Scott Columbus Jr. in the beginning of the match. And now, SCJ returning the favor, and it is Britt Diamond and Scott Columbus Jr. Part 3. SCJ dropping Britt Diamond with a drop kick. The Fairbanks failure, a success story in the Worldwide Wrestling Network, waiting for his opportunity to face Montezuma Cortez for the junior heavyweight title. That match is scheduled for St. Valentine's Massacre at the end of February. And we have barely seen a program with Scott Columbus Jr. and Montezuma Cortez, as Cortez has been tied up with Gaz Corbin and facing the Bennett era, and Scott Columbus Jr. has just been proving himself as the number one contender for the junior heavyweight title. Now, that is not saying Britt Diamond is not a slouch. Either beautiful moonsault standing by Scott Columbus Jr. Britt Diamond is a very, very talented performer and has very charismatic, shown that he is very capable in the ring. His only shortfall is he thinks he's great at everything. Just a week or so ago, last week, we saw him attempt a frog splash and just did not have the ups for it and paid for it dearly in the match. But we just saw him sucker in Scott Columbus Jr. Britt Diamond is very good with the psychological mind games. Oh, and a dragon suplex! Following that up, working the head with an old school camel clutch. Diamond sending in SCJ. SCJ able to step out of the way just long enough to catch the knee with Prince Britt Diamond. And now locking in the Rings of Saturn. We've seen Britt Diamond use this. We've seen Scott Columbus Jr. use this in this match. And it's almost like a game of one-upsmanship. Anything you can do, I can do better. And Britt Diamond taken down with the clothesline. Beautiful combination, that clothesline into the moonsault. And wait a minute, following it up with a rolling thunder. Scott Columbus Jr. feeling himself tonight. But wait a minute. Looks like he's going for a pump handle driver. I thought he was going for a pump handle slam. And look, Prince Diamond says it's all about me. And into that very, very disrespectful pose rolling through. Catching SCJ with forearms. One more time. Looks like he's going for the spine buster. And, catches the knee. Scott Columbus Jr. caught that knee. Irish whip by Britt Diamond. Diamond, and again, wait a minute, 450. A hair-raising 450 splash. And now attacking the elbow. Britt Diamond, chorus of boos, but this is what we saw last week. Does he have enough distance? Will he be able to connect? Oh no! Wait a minute, he did connect, but to the back of the head! And wait a minute, Scott Columbus Jr. answering with a dragon screw. Wait a minute, Snapmare Driver out of nowhere. Rocking Scott Columbus Jr.'s world. And knee drop. These two junior heavyweights bringing it all. Britt Diamond. Diamond, wait a minute, locking up. He's got him up. Oh, what a cutter. What a snap, spinning neckbreaker. One, two. And Britt Diamond almost connecting, almost winning with that neckbreaker. But SCJ answering back with a forearm shot. But wait, DDT! And that DDT collapses SCJ. Prince Britt Diamond. What is he looking for here? Drop kick. Cover. One, two. And Scott Columbus Jr. has got to get his mind in the right place, or Britt Diamond is gonna win this match. Locking in a camel clutch, picking that leg goes Scott Columbus. SCJ has got something in mind for Britt Diamond. Oh, it looked like he was going for Eat Defeat, the move that was so effective. And wait a minute, pile driver! Sit out Tombstone Pile Driver. And Britt Diamond up on the top, perched, waiting. And with the Frog Splash, cover. One, two. And the frustration, the absolute frustration of Britt on Prince Diamond's face. Britt Diamond. And look at this! And going back, I mean, the referee's gonna have to stop this match. The frustration. Again, going for the neck. And gouging the eyes at the same time. Desperation is written all over the face of Scott Columbus Jr. and his opponent. Oh, what a KO shot! Jr. rolled through, and that kick sending him right into the ropes. He is in the corner, but Brent breaking up the offense. Super kick! Super kick connects, and here comes SCJ. Cover, kick out. This match could have been the main event. These men are pouring out their heart and soul here. And eat defeat! Cover. One, two, no! These two men are the number one and number two contender for the junior heavyweight title. That is showing. This match right here is showing exactly what the Junior Heavyweight Championship means to those involved in the Worldwide Wrestling Network. This weight class is legendary. Showcased at Clash of the Super Juniors. Carried on in the tradition of the Cruiserweight Division of WCW. Emulated in the style of the American Indies today. And Diamond rolls to the outside, trying to catch a breather. And Scott Columbus Jr. daring Diamond to get back in. Oh, bicycle knee. Wait a minute, what has Diamond got in mind? Oh! Wheelbarrow neck breaker. Following this up, oh, with that running kick. Diamond. Suplex pile driver. And the cover. Is this it? One, two. Oh, well, look at this. Move after move after move after move. Scott Columbus Jr. not going down tonight. And again, butterfly twisting neck breaker. Cover. One, two. SCJ, this number one contendership means the world. Super kick from nowhere. Oh, and attempting at the eat defeat, Brent Diamond sends him over the top rope. And the disrespect, neither of these two men absolutely despise each other by this point. And the referee is counting. He has until the count of 10. Scott Columbus Jr. getting to his feet. Slapping the taste out of Brent Diamond's mouth. And now attempting to slow the pace just a bit with this body scissors. Pushing, forcing the oxygen out of Brent Diamond. And one more time, looking to lock in the Rings of Saturn. But Diamond able to break free. But struggled a little bit more that time. Gut punch by SCJ. Shoot him off into the ropes. And they meet in the middle. Wait a minute. Scott Columbus Jr. Ow! Snake eyes. Stun gun attempt. Attempting to use the rope like Stone Cold Steve Austin used to. And a curb stomp! assault. Diamond takes the leg, gets out from SCJ. Springboard. What a hurricane runner. Springboard hurricane runner by Scott Columbus Jr. Following it up with a curb stomp. Cover. One, two. And that kick creating some distance. Bicycle knee catching SCJ off guard. And wait a minute, will this be the last time he's got him up for that butterfly cutter? Cover. One, two, three. And Prince Brent Diamond able to score a victory.
Here is your winner, pretty boy, Prince Diamond.
And look at this. Look at this display by Prince Brent Diamond. Prince Brent Diamond showing that he is quite possibly one of the most dangerous junior heavyweights in the Worldwide Wrestling Network. Up next, we have a special treat for you, ladies and gentlemen. Fresh off, he's been gone for 3 weeks, Damian Knight. Fresh off of his altercation with Jonathan Cable at Krampus Night, taking a few weeks to recover to get himself right, we have got Damian Knight facing one of the standouts in the Krampus Night Junior Heavyweight Scramble in Outcast. Outcast has come to the Worldwide Wrestling Network and been incredibly impressive so far. And we will see Outcast versus Damian Knight coming right up. And with that, ladies and gentlemen, I want to take the opportunity. Please, 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 not only follow and subscribe to the Worldwide Wrestling Network online, why don't you also give a quick subscription to Trey41 Gaming, who does another e-fed called Pro Wrestling Revolution. While you're at it, why don't you swing by and look at that guy, Brian Evans' YouTube page, who does another show called Power Sport Wrestling. Sorry, those two guys are stand-up individuals on the YouTube scene. Guys that we have worked with in the Worldwide Wrestling Network. Give those guys a subscribe. Check out their notifications. Check out their streams. They do incredible work. And we are proud to call them friends of the Worldwide Wrestling Network. All right, guys. Let's check out Outcast versus Damian Knight. And here comes the Outcast, commissioning his own theme. Oh. only thing that we really know about the Outcast is that he is an exceptional fighter. Very tall, very lean, very focused.
He
works hard to maintain his frame at 225 pounds in order to be in contention for the junior heavyweight title. Next, we have got Damian Knight.
Symptoms of this virus include initial nausea,
Damian
and vomiting,
and
blurred vision, loss of muscle control, and unconsciousness.
One-on-one cage in the cage match at Krampus Night, where the winner had to knock out the loser and take you down. But he is not deterred. But what we have to look out from this from Damian Knight is the fact that he will do anything to prove a point. In his first match, he blew the green mist into the face of Jonathan Cape. Again, he viciously attacked and nearly completely injured Jack Sanders in a tag team match with him and Israel Hare. But taking nothing away, this man is an incredible professional wrestler. To see 20 minutes on the clock, Outcast versus Knight, Bicycle League leveling the Outcast, creating some distance and shoot kicks right to the frame of the Outcast, and the Outcast able to get the elbow. Oh, and what a lariat, taking down Knight. And, oh, big right hand by Damian. Outcast with the snapmare. And these two are absolutely pound for pound, going beat for beat, strike for strike, grapple for grapple. And a driving knee drop right into the throat of the Outcast. Outcast answering back with a shot right to the sternum. Outcast using the height advantage here to try to create some distance and separation, trying to use some speed to his advantage, but not really able to do it. He's in another light heavyweight class. And wait a minute. Wait a minute. That's... wait. What is going? That's Apollonius! What the hell? Apollonius dropping the Outcast. One, two. What in the hell? Apollonius showing up and attacking the Outcast from behind and giving, the referee didn't see a thing, and this is giving Damian Knight an unfair advantage here. What is the connection between Apollinus and Damian Knight? I'm aghast here. I'm a god. Look at it. It's strangling. We've seen that mean streak from Knight before. And look at this. Oh! And now Knight going up to the top rope. Outcast trying to get out of the way, but we've seen this moonsault! Beautiful moonsault! And now working the head, locking it in tight. And a side headlock applied by Outcast as well. I can't believe that the referee is letting this match continue after the blatant interference of Apollinus. The evangelist of pain cover. The minister of misery and attacking Outcast for no apparent reason. And Damian Knight, since then, has been the one getting the most out of, definitely got the advantage. Outcast with the Irish whip. Maybe this will be the offense that he's looking for, charging into the rope. And oh, full extension on that body splash. And boom! Big elbow right under the chin. The Outcast able to get a little bit of payback for what he has to assume was a setup or collusion on the part of Damian Knight and Apollinus. Takedown by Damian. And wait a minute, Damian Knight is removing the turnbuckle. And is he gonna do what I think he's gonna do? Yes, he is! Oh, right to the spine! And Outcast fighting through the pain. Fighting through the damage and a running knee taking down Damian Knight. Cover. Two. Kick out by Knight. The Outcast now looking to try to put a nail in the coffin of Damian Knight. And he's got him up. And hits him with that big sit-out driver. Is this it for Damian? Cover. One, two, and no. That ability to absorb pain ever apparent in the body of Damian Knight. And Outcast, wait a minute, arm drag, takes down the taller Outcast, who has received the gift of madness earlier from Apollinus. Damian Knight wanting the Outcast to get back into this ring, daring him, and Outcast slowly getting to his feet, slowly recovering. And wait a minute, Irish whip, and right. The referee, thankfully, placing the turnbuckle back in place. But now Outcast going for an attempt at a cheap victory there. Knight able to break out of it. And a top wrist lock applied, but Damian fighting back, clubbing those ribs with right hands. Knight not able to connect, but wait a minute, and Outcast not enough strength to pick up Damian Knight, and Knight with the angel wing. Cover. One, two, three.
Symptoms of this virus include
Damian Knight.
Vomiting, blurred vision, loss of muscle control, and unconsciousness.
Damian Knight. With a special assist from Apollonis, getting the victory over Outcast. But Damian Knight celebrating the victory. Is there a connection between Outcast and Apollonis? And ladies and gentlemen, that brings us to our main event of the evening. We just saw their leader interfere in that what was going to be a fantastic match between Outcast and Damian Knight, and upon a sticking his self, inserting himself into that match, leading to several questions. And up next, we have Jonathan the Beast Cable facing off against the Engine of Destruction. One quarter of the Disciples of Apollonis, Malthus. We saw the Disciples of Apollonis return on Monday Night Melee. And because we cannot control the goings and comings of these maniacs, they can show up wherever. Melee. They can show up on Cyclone Saturday Night. They can show up on Glow if they wanted to. These individuals are absolutely crazy. And I have to say that, I mean, the locker room is not afraid of these individuals, but I certainly am. The championship committee, made up of retired boxer Bruiser Barco, Gibson Ellis, former hardcore wrestler Tom Cole, and former Joshi superstar Kimiko Nissan, I've got to say, there is a fear, palpable fear, when the Disciples of Apollonis are around. It's in the air. And the fact that they also have a litigator like Lilith Anton as their advocate, it makes things 100% worse. But here comes one of the newest heroes in the Worldwide Wrestling Network, Jonathan Cable, who may look like a monster, but is one of the most giving and selfless individuals in professional wrestling. And Jonathan Cable able to score a victory over Damian Knight and Krampus Knight. We just saw Damian score a victory over the Outcast a moment ago. And Jonathan Cable looking to square off against Malthus. As the lights drop and the smoke fills the arena, and the Disciples of Apollonis travel in packs, Memphis, flanked by Crowley on the left and Lovecraft on the right.
And his opponent, accompanied by the superstar, and from New York, weighing in at 450 pounds, the superstar.
And you can hear the cheers of the crowd as Malthus flanked by his two brothers, Crowley and Lovecraft, make their way into the arena. Here we go, 2 minutes on the clock, the referee calls for the bell. And Malthus swatting away Cable like he was a fly. And this is a big man match. Two super heavyweights going at it. Oh, and look, oh my God. The strength of Malthus. Malthus with the Irish whip to the Beast. Finally, Jonathan Cable able to get some offense, but Malthus able to isolate and takes now with a shoulder breaker. This man is deceptively fast and agile for a man his size. Going quickly for a cover, looking to embarrass the Beast. And Cable able to answer back with an elbow shot right to the head. But look at that reversal by Malthus. And wait a minute, look, oh my God, oh my God, oh my God. Cable able to sidestep the engine of destruction, but look at that push creating the distance. Sending him rolling to the outside. Crowley headed that way. And wait a minute. Cable. Oh! Cable attempted that cross body block. Cut off by Malthus. Malthus with the, oh! Like I said, this is two big bruisers going at it. And look at the madness in the mind of Malthus, inflicting that damage on himself. Oh, and look at the left arm clothesline, cutting down Cable. Jonathan Cable has yet to face something like Malthus in the Worldwide Wrestling Network. And this mountain, this destructive force. Oh, it cuts off the Beast. Irish whip. And wait a minute, Cable. Cable looking like he might be able to get a little bit back in. Oh, looking at locking in a knee in Camel clutch, inflicting some damage on Malthus here, but Malthus picking a leg and just yanking it out, pulling the support like pillars. And, oh! Big kick Oh, wait a minute. Malpas looking to go for the big cannonball, and the Beast with the gutbuster. And now in control, monkey flip. That is less of a monkey flip and more of a gorilla flip. And the Beast staring down into the heart of his opponent. And I have no idea what Cable has in mind. And look, big stop. Wait a minute, and there's Crowley interjecting himself in this match, creating a distraction for Malphus. Malphus picking up Cable, and look, oh my God. Big power bomb. Ring shaking power bomb by Malphus to Jonathan Cable. Cable fighting back, able to break out of that grip. But like I said, this is a hoss battle if I've ever seen one. Cable with that hesitation neck breaker to Malphus, and he's got him up. Wait a minute, he has got him. Oh my God! Torture back into the pile jump. Crowley again inserting himself, keeping the referee from counting, giving Malphus another opportunity. And this is why the Disciples of Apollos are so efficient. And wait a minute, the referee, I think he's throwing out Crowley. That's right, Crowley is gone, but Lovecraft is still here. And the Beast is basically wrestling a gauntlet tonight. Cover. Referee's in position. One, kick out by Malphus. And an Irish whip. Oh! Big kick. Oh, wait, look at this! Nice leverage pin! Sneaking up, stacking him up, kick out! Unexpected possuming there by Big Jonathan Cable. Hard hammer throw, catching him into the Russian leg sweep. Cable putting together an incredible combination right there that would make Brad Armstrong proud. Oh! Blue Thunder Bomb! But there is Crowley. I mean, Lovecraft. Lovecraft is there, interjecting again on behalf of Malphus. That is the second time Jonathan Cable could have had this match won. And now picking up Malphus again. Oh! Absolutely breathtaking. Cover. One, two, and Malphus. Malphus, this big engine, this big monster, just doesn't know when to quit like a golem. And now, Jonathan Cable is in one of the most dangerous positions of his wrestling career. On The inside is the engine of destruction. Malphus on the outside is the buzzsaw disciple, Lovecraft. And Malphus throwing his weight around the clothesline. Cable attempting to create some distance with that kick. And now stomping away on the legs of Malphus, trying to cut down the tree trunk of the engine of destruction. Forearm shot by Cable. Cable, big hammer throw, clothesline. Rocking that ring post, bombing it up with a snapmare. And wait a minute, tying up Malphus. We've not seen this from Cable, literally tying him up. Oh, big right hand. And oh no, 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 no. Oh! How did he get Cable up at Malphus? Malphus with the win. Oh my God. Jonathan Cable.
Here is your winner,
no longer undefeated in singles competition. And Malphus is the monster that did it. Oh my God. Jonathan Cable is not going to be happy about this. Ladies and gentlemen, that concludes our broadcast for the evening. Thank you, everyone, for checking out the Worldwide Wrestling Network online. Find us on Twitter at WWWN Capital O Online. And please, if you like what you see, hit the subscribe button, slap that notification bell, and let us know, and come back for more. And in the words of Lord Cyrus, stay safe and stay over.